In this lesson, we're gonna learn how to use some code and when to use it in our Velo site. So there's a lot of different scenarios where you're gonna be creating different interactive experiences for your site visitors. And you can do that by selecting different elements on the page. As you know, Velo works in tandem with Wix, so there's plenty of tools that you have already built in to work with elements that we have on our page. So from anything from a button, some text, maybe even an image, those things all count as elements. Even the page itself is an element that you can change the ID of. And these IDs help us select a certain element on the page and give it a name so we can work with our code. And it's just easier for us as developers to work through and select that specific element that we want to change and add some functions to. So if you're familiar with HTML and CSS, you'll know that there's something called getElementById, right? But when we're using Velo by Wix, it's a bit different. We're just using JavaScript. So we have an API called $w, and we can actually use that to select a specific element on the page and add functionality that we want to it. So we can see here from our page, we have some elements here already. So this text, it's labeled as text 47. This other text is labeled as welcome. This one's text 48. And even this button's button 11. So these names aren't very useful when we're going to be developing our website. And we want to change it to something a little bit more related to what we're using this function as. So text 47, we can change it to something different. And we can change it to welcome message, right? And notice how I type this in camel case. And camel case is just a way for us to, as developers, to see how much more readable our code is, instead of just having one long-winded word. So we have our default values already there for hidden and collapse. You know, those are very useful, but these are more static. And throughout this course, we're going to be focusing more on dynamic experiences because we can do this with code. So let's start out by looking at what $w is and how to use it. So we could just type here in our onReady function that says $wOnReady. An onReady function is there so that when the page loads, it actually starts to use the functions that we have inside of it. So anything that's there is already going to get ready to go as soon as the user visits our page. So if we go right here at the bottom, we'll see that there's a few other experiences that I have built in. So I even have our Wix Animations API that's here, where I have an animation running with this astronaut. So let's just see what this looks like. It's inside of our onReady function. You see I've imported Wix animations. I have some functions here just to make our spaceman float. And we'll go here to preview. And as soon as the page loads, we'll see our astronaut floating up and down. Cool. But let's add our own other experience to maybe hide this welcome message that we had at the top. So instead of our $wOnReady function, we're going to add and select that exact element for the welcome message. So we'll just type in $w, and we'll type in welcome message. And the autocomplete's already helping us out. So choose welcome message, and we can add some more properties to this message. So let's say I want to hide it dynamically instead of static, just like how we had it here on the side. So we could have done this the static way by selecting the option for hidden or collapse. But let's just do this with code, because it's what if we want to create some other custom functionality and have it hide afterwards? If I was to just use this from the static version from the default values here, I wouldn't be able to add that. So we have $w, welcome message, that element is selected. And let's add a property. So just do a period here. And then we get some more autocomplete options. So this just shows you exactly, depending on the data type of that element, which properties are available for you to use. So I just want to hide this message on load, just to show you, for example, what this looks like. And let's go in and look at that. So I can go here and click hide, or I can type it in, whatever way is easier for me. Velo is great because it definitely increases the velocity when you are developing these websites. And we'll go here and click hide. And we'll just see from when we click preview mode, what this looks like and if that welcome message is actually going to be there. So let's click preview. And our welcome message is gone. So that's how you use $W in order to select an element and add functionality. There's a few other things that you can do. You can add in functional program where I can create functions outside of this $W on ready function and just call the function itself, or I can write the function straight inside of our on ready function in the beginning. So we'll go back to our editor. And we're gonna check out another example that I have here on the page as well that you may be a little bit more familiar with when it comes to using a website. So imagine you're going to a website page and there's a button there that says read more, and then all of a sudden some more additional text starts to show up. So this is a great example that you see on a ton of websites across the web. So let's recreate that experience right now with some code and see how that operates with Velo. So here I actually have an example already ready to go with read more. So I have some text here that I have grouped together. I even have this space message, and then I also have this additional text. And this is just some messages giving you our perspective on what space is, since this is a space theme website. So we'll go here to preview. So you see I have some messages here already letting me know a little bit more about space that I probably didn't know already beforehand. And we'll click read more. And then some more additional text pops up. So now you know how to write code and also select an element on the page and add some interactivity to it. But you still might be wondering how these scenarios go and where to add your code. So in the next lesson, we're going to learn how to get your page ready to go. And we're also going to add some more experiences to our website and show you how to really add some more custom functionality and create a whole different type of experience for your site visitors. So thanks for watching this lesson, and we'll catch you in lesson number 3.